This is a Swede Speaks.
Hi, it's time to talk about This Week in Sweden. I haven't done this for a few weeks. I'm sorry about this. I have been very busy. I have been working on getting to know my new equipment. There has been a lot of things going on. I've been flooded and I'm in a steep learning curve here. But let's get back to business and let's talk about This Week in Sweden. Or Last Week in Sweden, I mean. So, last Sunday, September 17th, 2017, in Hörby, in Skåne, during the church election in Hörby, the ballot papers from the Sweden Democrats were missing. Every party gets their own ballot paper in Sweden. The chairman for the Sweden Democrats in Hörby, a man named Johan Olin, accused the church election there of voting fraud, and said that he was going to report this to the police. Ylva Johansson, Sweden's Minister for Employment, said that the situation in the Swedish job market is immediately difficult. The unemployed in Sweden lacks the necessary skills for the jobs available. In Nacka, in Södermanland, Nacka municipality, to the south of Stockholm, bought three houses for a Syrian man with three wives and 16 children, one for each wife. The municipality still owns the houses and they are renting them out to the family. The cost of the houses were altogether 13,950,000 Swedish kronor, roughly 1,750,000 US dollars, and the family is living on benefits. On Monday, September 18th, it was reported that all eight parties in the Swedish parliament are in agreement on abolishing the TV license. The license that funds Sveriges Television, Swedish Television, which is the public service broadcaster. However, they also agree upon instituting a TV tax instead for everyone who pays taxes in Sweden, no matter if you own a TV or not. For most taxpayers, this will mean a TV tax of 1,300 Swedish kronor, roughly 165 US dollars per year. Only if you make less than 130,000 Swedish kronor, something like $16,500 per year, you will get a lower tax. What also happens is that now it won't help if you refuse to have a TV, you will still have to pay the tax. What can I say? Nice job! All eight parties! I'm sarcastic, by the way. And also on Monday, September 18th, in the neighborhood of Hovsjö, in Södertälje, in Södermanland, police were attacked by youngsters who threw so-called bangers, a strong kind of crackers, at the police. On Tuesday, September 19th, 2017, in the neighborhood of Södermalm in Stockholm, a pedestrian walking in the cycling lane was assaulted by a cyclist who hit the pedestrian in the head with his bicycle lock. The pedestrian was brought to hospital. And according to a survey, violence and disturbances have increased a lot in the Swedish libraries during the last 2 years. For the last 2 years, it has been getting worse. 73% of librarians say that they have experienced social unrest in their libraries, including visitors fighting with each other and gangs ravaging the halls. On Wednesday, September 20th, in Luleå, in Norrbotten, in the north of Sweden, after having their car vandalized several times, a couple put a camera in a birdhouse to figure out what was going on. After an anonymous tip to the police, they were charged with illegal surveillance. In Malmö, in Skåne, the Swedish government wants to open a museum for democracy and migration in Malmö, according to the government's cultural budget. Also on Wednesday, September 20th, in Vellinge, in Skåne, Vellinge Municipal Council voted to outlaw begging in the municipality, effective from January 1st, 2018. The ban was proposed by the Moderate Party and supported by the Sweden Democrats and the Liberal Party. On Thursday, September 21st, the Swedish National Council for Crime Prevention published statistics showing that only 8% of the rapes reported so far in 2017 have been solved. 8%, let that sink in. In Gothenburg, At Skånegatan, a street in central Gothenburg, there were two fights during first day. In the later fight, roughly 80 people were involved. And in the neighborhood of Gottsunda, in Uppsala, in Uppland, two persons were arrested during Thursday evening. They were brought in for questioning concerning preparation for murder. After this, gang members threatened the police with revenge. And yesterday, Friday, September 22nd, in Norrköping, in Östergötland, after a fight at a restaurant in central Norrköping, two persons were injured and three persons were arrested suspected of attempted murder, alternatively attempted manslaughter. Also yesterday, September 22nd, in Kristinehamn in Värmland, two persons were arrested after a fight at the checkout at a Coop store in Kristinehamn. The fight started when staff wanted to check the purchases the two customers were self-scanning. Police says that they were not scanning all their purchases. And in Kristianstad, in Skåne, it was reported that because of sales of narcotics, threats and vandalization, work started with putting up a fence around a local school in the city called Villans Gamla Skola. Villans Gamla Skola. So that's some of the stories that came out of Sweden last week, or this week. And that's really all I have to say about this. So, I intend to make another this week in Sweden, or another last week in Sweden, next Saturday. So until then, have a nice day, and God bless.